Well, have you heard? The cat's out of the bag in a big way. The actors from the cast of Cats playing in our area in Wolf Trap this weekend are here with us in the studio.
They have arrived. They're not only going to tell us about their experience with this awesome show, but we're also minutes away from this big reveal with our segment producer, Whitney. It's her full Cats makeover. That is so neat. Look at that.
Coming along really well.
Tug Watson is working on her right now. He was back in the makeup room with me doing his makeup, and I said, you know, Tug, I could borrow your foundation. I'm about that color. we're both pale, but anyway, this is so neat what he does. We're going to check in with them. First, we're going to get to two cast members. Aubrey Elson takes on the role of Syllabub, and Kristen Quartarone is the cat known as Rumpled Teaser. What
names?
Aren't they great?
Yes, they're crazy.
Good to have you both here.
Yeah, thank you.
So this play has just has such staying power. Why do people love Cats for, you know, 20, 30 years? It's still a great musical. Great
yes,
show.
It is. The American musical usually tends to be very loud and in your face, and Cats, when it came about, it was a very different show. I mean, the entire show was dancing, and it had a very English sensibility to it, so it was just a completely different take on an American musical than what the audiences have or were used to. So it was a big shocker, and it has stuck with the audiences.
And for a new generation that may be seeing it for the first time, maybe you can tell us what is the show, you know, what is the plot line here with the Cats?
The very basic plot is that this is the one night of the year that all the cats get together. It's called the Jellicle Ball, and one cat specifically is going to get chosen to go up to the Heaviside Lair, which is kind of an ambiguous term for kitty heaven, if you will. And so you get introduced to various cats throughout the evening, and the whole point is wondering which cat is going to get chosen. And throughout all this, you have this older cat named Grisabella, who's kind of been shunned by the rest of the tribe, as we call it. And she keeps trying to come back into the evening's events, and the other cats won't have anything to do with her. So it's also kind of a story about redemption, acceptance, family.
And makeup. The great makeup on stage. How do you guys gear up? I guess the makeup helps to get into character and channel that energy to be a cat.
Well, we are there 2 hours before the show, and it takes me, it depends on the cat and the makeup plot that you have to put on your face. It takes me about 40 minutes to do my makeup, and then you have to have your wig pinning, and then you get into costume, and we have a warm-up.
Does everybody do their own makeup?
Yes. Yes, wow. We all have
well,
a certain
plot.
How do
you learn to do that? Do they teach you how to do that when you come on board?
Yes, when we're in rehearsals, we learn how to do our own makeup. They first do it on us, and then we have to do it ourselves the next time, and the more you do it, the better you get at it. First few times, it's not good.
You know, Melanie, look at Kristen's eyes.
I know,
must looking pop at in
them.
That makeup because they're beautiful.
Yes,
they really pop.
She probably was picked partly because
her eyes
sparkle. Yes, absolutely.
It must go with that makeup.
Yeah.
Now, you guys are going to be at Wolf Trap, of course, this weekend, but I've got to talk to you about the Vegas trip that you just came off of. They just told us this in the commercial break. You had about 6 days off to party, right?
Yes, we did.
Yeah.
Which
is a tough life.
Yeah.
You know, we do work extremely hard. We had, right before that, we had several performances straight without a break. So
you deserved that 6 days off.
It was kind of necessary,
yeah.
And it was a great experience just to be able to perform at Planet Hollywood, which is huge, and we're told on par with Wolf Trap in terms of size. So it was really cool, and just get to like see the cities, you know.
Have you guys not been out to Wolf Trap yet?
No, tonight.
You know, the neat part about that is just it's open, you know, and so I don't know. I like going there for concerts and other things. Have you been there, Mel, for a concert?
I have been there, one time. But you know what? I was thinking with the weather this weekend, we're expecting very hot, humid, 90-degree, sticky weather, and I'm thinking, here you are in your cat suits and all that makeup.
Yes,
are you at all worried? How are you going to deal with that?
Well,
we're kind of used to it.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
We performed for 6 weeks in South America, and it was very,
very humid.
Oh, hot and humid.
Very humid,
yeah.
The whole time. So,
wow.
You just kind of learn to live with the sweat.
Yeah. It's part of the jobs and the
very
lights.
Very sweaty. Yes. Yeah.
How much? I guess you're all dancers, so you're used to being very active. But I mean, these shows are very strenuous, right?
They are. Yes. I mean, it's 2 hours of dancing constantly, and I mean, we have a physical therapist with us who travels with us, and we use him a lot before the show, after the show.
You guys could probably eat what you want.
I was thinking the same thing.
You're so active, you know, that when I was younger, you know, you could eat anything you wanted. I was a dance, and my mom always said, it's going to catch up with you. But you guys have an active lifestyle, so you probably can kind of gorge if you want.
Sometimes, I mean, your body does tend to get acclimated to the show, so it gets to a point where it's still hard, but it's not even necessarily a workout, you know, because your body's so used to the movement. So a lot of our cast actually also goes to the gym, goes running, like everyone has their own thing, does yoga, Pilates, and you know,
very
on
cool.
top
Stay
of the
in shape.
Sounds like you have a good time.
Aubrey, Kristen, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
We're gonna now look outside to what's happening with Tug, the makeup artist, and Whitney, our segment producer. Is she done? I think she's just about done. Look at that. She is transformed. Now, this only took what? I mean, 20, 30 minutes? We started about 30 minutes ago. That's impressive. Now, you guys, Aubrey and Kristen, how long does it take to do your makeup?
It takes me about 40 minutes.
40 minutes?
About 30.
So that's pretty good. Oh, there they are. They make such a nice-looking couple.
Do you guys, you have microphones on? You can talk to us out there?
Yes.
Oh,
yes,
there
I
you are.
Hear
okay.
you.
So, Whitney, what does it feel like with all that makeup on your face?
It actually doesn't feel that heavy. You know, I can still, it's not sticky, but it just feels really natural. It's nice.
I've got to ask you, how many weird looks are you guys getting outside in Arlington?
We have a few stragglers on the street. We have cars passing by honking and waving because they just don't know what's going on. But
you've attracted some attention.
We
That's
have.
Funny.
Now, Tug, it looks like you made up Whitney to look sort of like you.
Yes, he did. He doesn't have a microphone on, but he did to make it look exactly like him. So, and he's a pro. This is amazing.
Oh, absolutely he is. It's great.
There's the before picture of Whitney. Beautiful, of course.
Absolutely. We would never have recognized her if we'd seen her just this way.
So, Whitney, are you getting the Broadway bug now?
Yes, I want to go on. I want to be a cat. Somebody hire me.
All right. Practice
you
your best
great.
Cat
yeah.
crawl.
Thank you for being a good sport. We'll see you in a second.
Thank you.
Yeah, you
All
do
right.
look great.
Thanks, guys.
And thanks
Have
to
a
both
good
of you.
Here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So break a leg or a cat paw or whatever it is that you say.
Coming up on the show.